use as a theme this morning, a heart transplant. Now, scripture has already been read for our hearing. Church, we're living in a time where heart disease is on the rise. And it seems as if every day we live, either there is someone close to us, a neighbor, a friend, or even a relative living far away, has been diagnosed with heart disease. The doctor gives medicine and the other treatments to help persons cope with this disease. And depending upon the condition of the heart, medicine will not work, and the other treatments will not. Then the physician informs us because of the condition of the heart, we need a heart transplant if we are going to live. And according to the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute, heart transplants are done as a life-saving measure for end-stage heart failure when medical treatment and less drastic surgery have all failed. And about 88% of patients survive the first year after transplant surgery, and 72% survive for 5 years. The 10-year survival rate is close to 50%, and 16% of heart transplant patients survive 20 years. And my beloved friends, our Savior Jesus Christ, who loves us beyond measure, He wants us to offer a heart transplant so that we will not only live in the here and now, but life eternally. Well, somebody is saying this morning, well, what is wrong with my heart? Well, I've had it for years. Yes, this may be true, but as men and women of God, we have used our hearts as a storage center, as a storage room, where we have stored all kinds of sin. Sin as jealousy, such as greed, such as envy, such as bitterness and wrath. And we've allowed these things to take root in our lives. And therefore, we need to ask God, like David did, to come into our lives and get rid of those things that are holding us down. Can I get a witness? I hear somebody sing, well, my heart is in good condition. Well, all well in will consume us. David allowed sin to be conceived in his heart. Therefore, we got to be careful what we allow into our space. Can I get a witness? As Christians, we can't allow any and everything to come in our territory. Can I get a witness? Tell the Lord, thank you. He allowed the world to take root into his life. Instead of David dealing with sin, his shortcomings came in, and glory be to God, they consumed him. And just like many of us, if we are not careful, we got to remember that our sins do not go away. Amen. The stain of sin becomes larger and larger as we feed it. And as Christians, we need to be reminded that sin is like leprosy, or to put it in modern day terms, it's like cancer. It spreads like wildfire. Can I get a witness? you to have a heart that loves. I want you to have a spirit that loves. But Christ says, in order for us to get to where we need to be, we got to learn how to repent of our sins. See, David thought he had it all together. Anybody been like David? Where you thought you had it all together? And then the Lord sends somebody your way, and the Lord reveals to you, I know what you're done. Give you a new heart.